J-Steel, along with their sister company, Westside Steel, are companies that specialize in laser cutting and steel fabrication. They currently utilize a commercial deburring machine that requires the parts to be fed in twice, once for the top side and once for the bottom side of each part. They came to NDSU's mechanical engineering department looking for a machine that could achieve the same quality but in a single pass. The machine requires a consistent deburring method to remove the slag, along with deburring the edge.
The team began utilizing modeling software to design the machine, while also going through different options for key components. We decided on a two conveyor belt system with magnets underneath the belts. The part would be placed on the bottom belt to get deburred, then the magnets would pull the part to the top belt, where they would be deburred by the abrasives from underneath. The deburring mechanism was placed at an angular offset to the direction of the part flow to reduce the force on the shaft. A height adjustment system would also be in the design for different size parts.
The abrasive drums were then tested at the desired 3400 RPM to ensure it would effectively remove the slag and sharp corners. Creo files were then sent to Chase Steel for part fabrication to begin the build. The conveyor frame was constructed and the belt was cut to length and connected with hammer-on clips. The bottom conveyor was then mounted to the welded frame and the belt was tightened around the rollers. The top conveyor was assembled with magnets under a thin layer of high-density polyethylene to allow for the parts to move along the belt smoothly. The top conveyor system was then mounted to the machine as well as the corner tubes and top piece of the frame. The conveyor motors and magnet strength was then tested using a part supplied by Chase Steel.
It's still bad.
No, it's going.
Heavy parts don't get stuck. No, switch.
It's too far away. Oh! Let's go! The team decided that the height adjustment mechanism would be a single point screw jack with bushings along the four corner tubes. Using the Creo model, the center of gravity of the top conveyor assembly was found in order to determine where this jack should be placed. Once the bushings were welded on, the assembly needed to be adjusted to reduce binding. This was the only crucial setback in the assembly of the machine, but after some light hammering of the frame and buffing of the guide rails, the height adjustment lifted evenly. The final step was to wire the abrasive motors and turn it on.